Hello friends and welcome to English Factory. Today we are going to do class 12 first poem of Flamingo, My Mother at 66. Mothers are God's greatest gift to humanity. Each one of us has the fear of losing our mother, isn't it? In the poem My Mother at 66, the poet Kamala Das talks about her mother. This is a very touching poem based on mother-daughter relation and the poet shares her feelings for her mother. Before we start understanding the poem, let's first read about the poet. The poet Kamala Das, also known as Kamala Surayu, was born on 31st March 1934 in Malabar, Kerala. She was an Indian English poet and literator and at the same time a leading Malayalam author. Her popularity in Kerala is based chiefly on her short stories and autobiography written under name Madhavi Kutti. While her obra in English written under the name Kamala Das is noted for the poems and explicit autobiography. What is the theme or central idea of the poem? Let's see. Aging is an important phase of human life. A person enters his childhood and experiences youth when he is full of energy and dreams to have luxury of life. Finally, he approaches his old age and encounters death. Relationship between people becomes stronger at every aspect of life and they can't bear separation due to aging. Get started with the explanation now. Here the poet Kamala Das explains. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me. The poetess explains that once when she visited her parents' house in Cochin, it was a Friday when she was driving back to the airport. Her mother was sitting beside her at the back of the car. The poet looked at her mother. Doze open mouth, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain. Here the poet explains, she saw that her mother was sleeping and her mouth was open. She further explains that the color of her mother's face was like that of ash. This means that there was some smoky appearance on her face. She looked like a dead body. That she was as old as she looked, but soon put that thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling out of their homes. The poetess realized that her mother had grown old. She felt pain for her, but soon she tried to get rid of this sad thought by diverting her thoughts towards the trees outside. The young trees, although stationary, seemed to be running very fast, as though they were sprinting. She also saw children running out of their houses into the playground. All these things were full of life and energy, contrary to her mother who sat next to her. But after the airport security check, standing a few yards away, I looked again at her, wan, pale. The poet continues that when she reached the airport, she finished with the security check and stood a few yards away from her mother. She noticed her mother's aging face, which looked so dull, weak and pale. As a late winter's moon and felt that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear. But all I said was, see you soon, Amma. All I did was smile and smile and smile. The poet compares her mother to a late winter's moon, as the moon in winters is not shiny and even her mother's face had also lost her youth and shine. As her mother was getting older and weak, the poet feels the fear of separation just as she used to feel during her childhood. As a child, she could not bear the pain of separating from her mother. But now, as her mother has grown old and is about to die, the poet feels that maybe this is the last time that she is seeing her mother. She tries to hide her fear. She then says that she would soon see her mother again. She says so because she doesn't want to lose her mother. In the last line, she deliberately smiled and smiled just to hide her fear of losing her and a hope of seeing her next time when she comes back. So children, as I told you in the beginning, this poem is very touching. Always love and respect your mother as you will not get another. Now look at the vocabulary used in the poem. Wan, which means colorless, pallid. Late winter's moon, that is dim moon shrouded by clouds. Spilling means run out. Ashen means grey. Ache means pain. And the meaning of sprinting is short, fast race or running. The poetic devices which are used in the poem are simile, wan, pale as a late winter's moon. Her mother's face is compared with a late winter's moon. Her face ashen like that of a corpse. Mother's face is compared with a dead body. Next is metaphor, the merry children spilling out of their homes, which means the children are full of life coming out of their homes. Next figure of speech used is personification, young trees sprinting. Although the trees are stationary, but with the moving car it seems that the young trees full of life are running on the road. Next is repetition. The word smile is repeated thrice to reinforce the poet's hiding the fear behind her smile. Let's check out the most important questions of the poem My Mother at 66. 1. What do the parting words of the poet and her smile signify? The poet's parting words, "See you soon, Amma," signify both her farewell to her mother and an effort to leave her with optimism and cheer. They also enable the poet to empathize with the sense of isolation faced by her mother in the old age. Her smile signifies her helplessness at the face of her mother's inevitable death. They express her love and concern for her mother, along with the underlying pain and struggle that she undergoes in coming to terms with the bitter realization. Question number 2. Why are the young trees described as sprinting? The poet is driving to the Cochin airport. When she looks outside, the young trees seem to be walking past them. With the speed of the car, they seem to be running fast or sprinting. The poet presents a contrast, her dozing old mother and the sprinting young trees. Question 3. Why has the poet brought in the image of the merry children spilling out of their homes? The poet has brought in the image of merry children spilling out of their homes to present a contrast. The merry children coming out of their homes in large numbers present an image of happiness and spontaneous overflow of life. This image is in stark contrast to the dozing old mother, whose ashen face looks lifeless and pale like a corpse. She is an image of aging, decay and passivity. The contrast of the two images enhances the poetic effect. Number 4. Why has the mother been compared to the late winter's moon? The poet's mother is 66 years old. Her shrunken ashen face resembles a corpse. She has lost her shine and strength of youth. Similarly, the late winter's moon looks hazy and obscure. It too lacks shine and strength. The comparison is quite natural and appropriate. The simile used here is apt as well as effective. Question number 5. What is the kind of pain and ache that the poet feels? When the poet sees the pale and corpse-like face of a mother, her old familiar pain or the ache returns. Perhaps she has entertained this fear since her childhood. Aging is a natural process. Time and aging spare none. Time and aging have not spared the poet's mother and may not spare her as well. With this aging, separation and death becomes inevitable. Question number 6. How universal is the theme of the poet, My Mother at 66? All of us are deeply attached to our parents. We grow up watching them strong and powerful. Slowly we see them aging when we are growing. There is always a sudden realization of their appearance, which changes with time. The poet is deeply saddened by her aging mother and her likeness to someone who is nearing death. The fear of realizing this is universal because as human beings, the modes of our attachments are universal. Here I come to an end of today's lesson. Hope you have gained much out of it. Please like, share and subscribe our channel for the upcoming videos and press the bell icon for notification. Follow our Instagram ID, link is given in the description box. Thank you and have a good day ahead.